Hi everyone, I'm Maria Pozzi and I'm a postdoc at the University of Siena. I'm now presenting a work that was conducted in collaboration with the University of Perugia, and the main contribution of this work is a reactive collision avoidance algorithm for the teleoperation of a micro-aerial vehicle. So the idea is to endow the robot with the capability of autonomously avoiding obstacles, and this can help naive pilots to safely navigate even in unknown environments. We assume that the robot has an RGB camera on board, and we reconstructed the depth map thanks to RGB data through a convolutional neural network. The adopted strategy for collision avoidance is based on virtual force fields. Similarly to a previous article, we defined safety areas around the map, but differently from them that actually assume to have obstacles that have an infinite height and are cylindrical, we do not make any assumption on the shape of the obstacles. Here you see our algorithm tested in a simulated environment. The robot is commanded to go straight. Then, as soon as it detects obstacles, it avoids them. When no obstacle is detected, the robot continues to go straight. In the other video, you can see the depth map estimated from RGB data through the convolutional neural network. So let us see more details about the system. We have a vision module that takes as input an RGB image and does the depth estimation, the point cloud generation, and the voxelization. The voxelized point cloud is then fed into the force field module, which does the collision zones detection and the force field computation. The output of this module is fed to the reactive velocity computation module, which also takes into account the user's command and then generates the map motion. So what happens inside this module is that if no obstacle is detected, the user command is given to the MAV directly. Otherwise, if an obstacle is detected, a reactive velocity is computed so that the MAV actually can avoid the obstacle. So here we see how we defined the three collision zones. If an obstacle is detected inside the detection zone C, no repulsive force is computed. Then instead, if an obstacle is detected inside the avoidance zone, sigma, then we start computing a repulsive force so that the robot can actually avoid the obstacle. Instead, if an obstacle is detected inside the critical zone, it might be too late for the robot to actually avoid the collision. So that's why we start the action of repulsion of the robot as soon as we enter the sigma zone. To test our approach, we performed experiments in simulation using Unreal Engine 4 with AirSim plugin, and we chose environments that could be realistic in the sense that they present a lot of obstacles. In the first video that you see, the robot is commanded to always keep the same height, whereas in the second one, the height is left free. We performed a total of 30 experiments and we never observed collisions. Future work will focus mainly on two topics. First, we will let the drone follow a desired trajectory so that after avoiding an obstacle, the robot goes back to the desired path. Second, we will investigate whether adding some feedback on the operator side, for example, haptic feedback, can help the collaboration between the two agents. In particular, we will create a bilateral communication between the human and the robot. So to summarize, in this work, we present a reactive collision avoidance algorithm for the teleoperation of micro-aerial vehicles. Thank you for your attention.